said too much about, but he was fifth fastest, Damon, in the Williams in that second qualifying session. And we didn't really see it, but he's going really, really well here, isn't he?
Yeah, he's looking strong. I think he's starting to show signs of becoming a very solid driver. Again, Williams also coming on strong as time goes by, building. They've got a Toyota engine, and Toyota are showing well too. So there's a combination there that could come good. But no one's going to touch the McLarens at the moment, I think. Ferrari may do, but they're looking pretty dominant as we watch the leader of the pack there, who's bringing them round to start the main business of the afternoon.
Yeah, this is the phase where they put a few laps in, just get the cars set up the way they want them to. Usually they burn off about to get right underneath Alonso's car. At that point, Ted Kravitz, what can you tell us?
Yeah, just while we wait for news from Ferrari, very annoyed down here at Renault. They feel that Mark Webber in the Red Bull held up Heikki Kovalainen on his run. I just got a word with Heikki. He said, well, yes, he did kind of hold me up, but I probably wouldn't have gone much quicker. So we'll wait and see if there's any protest on that. But just on the, Damon, on the reason why Lewis can wait at the end of the pit lane like that, apparently it's because the Mercedes is able to go into a mode where it only runs on four cylinders. It cuts four cylinders out, just runs on a V4, which helps the cooling.
Well, not so many years ago, the engines, if they were left running like that, they would just burst into flames. I mean, they can't get rid of the heat. There's no fans on the car, so the radiators are fantastic when the cars are moving. But if they're not moving, they're a bit like sharks, you know, they can't breathe when they're standing still or something like that.
Well, you won here back in 93, again in 95. You almost memorably won here in 97 in an Arrows on Bridgestone tyres with a Yamaha engine in the back. Unfortunately, Jack Villeneuve spoiled the party that day and took it away from you at the very end. But you obviously have what it takes to go quick around the Hungaro Ring. What does it take? What's the secret then for Hamilton now? What's he got to unlock to beat Alonso?
Well, people ask me, you know, what secret, what can I give to Hamilton? I can't give anything. The guy's got everything he needs, you know. He is fantastic. And he's gone out this weekend in attacking mode. You can see him. He actually went off once, but he was trying and he had a car on the track in front of him. That's the reason why. But, you know, if you don't try, you don't find out where the limit is. And he's just been, you know, banging in the laps and showing that he's going to fight all the way.
What is the fastest way around this racetrack? What's the secret?
Well, it's got some long corners. It's got four 180-degree corners in it. And so the significance of that is that the tyres and the whole car is having to work for a very long time. So you have to feel comfortable with the car on the entry. It's a long corner. You've got to go in deep and you've got to stay hard into the apex and get on the power early and just be comfortable with the car.